Hi, I'm Anthony Leonardi, campus correspondent at Campus Reform. Today we're at the University of Florida asking students about the recent news of Justice Clarence Thomas coming to campus next semester to give an exclusive lecture series. We're going to be talking to students about how they feel about that. Let's go. So what are your thoughts on Supreme Court Justice Clarence Thomas coming to campus to give an exclusive lecture series for law students?
Obviously, it's a pretty big thing to protest about. Sexual assault's a super big deal, especially in recent years, all the cases that are coming out more and more.
My concern is the safety of students. When this decision was made, students were not asked whether they would feel comfortable or safe in a classroom with someone who has been credibly accused of sexual harassment in the workplace.
I think it's an interesting opportunity for students to get involved in and be interactive with a Supreme Court justice. I mean, whether people align with his politics or not, it's an interesting learning experience for everyone.
Well, some people have come out in protest because of the allegations of sexual misconduct approximately 30 years ago by Anita Hill. And a recent group has emerged of UF Law Believes survivors. And they said that they are uncomfortable with him giving the lecture series on campus. Do you think that those allegations disqualify him from coming to lecture students?
No. I think protesting is stupid. Either, go and listen to what he says and then come out with something better, like a better, opinion or something. Or just, stay home. Why do you have to discourage people from going? Like, you make people scared to go.
I think because he's a Supreme Court justice, we should let him on campus. There's a wealth of knowledge that we can learn from him being on the bench.
And as a law student was, it's pretty exciting to have a sitting Supreme Court justice come to campus.
It's an excellent opportunity for the UF faculty to offer the students here.
Every student would have to go through in their own mind of, do I feel comfortable and do I feel safe in this space? And is that...
Do you think that he would harm, when you say safe, just to be clear, do you think that he would harm students that would be attending his lecture? Or what do you mean by safe?
I can't speak to what his future actions would be. All I can speak to is that someone testified under oath in front of Congress that this particular thing happened to him, or to her, by him.
I don't think it's extremely appropriate that he's coming to a college campus. Places where students should definitely feel safe all the time, and unfortunately that doesn't always happen. So for him to come and speak here is kind of a scratch your head type of moment for most people.
Or I have found at least that there is some sort of dissonance in coming forward and saying, we are here for you, we're going to provide extra mental health counseling, we're going to have other people to talk to, this is a trigger warning.
I think that there's merit to the claims. It also doesn't disqualify his knowledge on law. But those aren't mutually exclusive.
When you're dealing with really anything Clarence Thomas, the history is going to come up. So it's a good thing that students are thinking about the impacts of the sexual allegations against him.
Was it proven? Like, it's 30 years ago. He's been doing a good job on the Supreme Court. Where's, no other problems with that whatsoever.
Making it a political issue in the court of public opinion is not the way to go about getting justice for survivors. Mm.